Hello, I am Michael. Today I'm going to learn you how to use Blender to improve your skinning. It's pretty easy. This is an example of what we're going to do without the anime characters, of course. You need a few softwares. You need War Thunder Asset Viewer, War Thunder, of course, Blender, and any editing software like GIMP, Photoshop, Clip Studio, any software you want. I will link everything you need into the description. So let's get going. First, we're going to go into War Thunder. Then, if we are into War Thunder, we're going to look up the file we want. I want a Panther A. So, customization. That was modification. Customization. And then we create a new file. Then you get this pop-up saying the file's been created. Then we go to our user skin file. I have already opened here. And then it will look like this. Most of this we won't need. Don't get overwhelmed. We won't need lots of it. We only want the names of the BLK actually. We can remove everything besides the BLK. Then we go to Asset Viewer and we look up the file we want. We want the Panther Eye, I already did it. So like here's the files. We need bijvoorbeeld the body, the gun, the turret, everything you want to skin you will need. But we only going to focus on the body. So we will export the DS to this file we created. Opslaan. So be saved now. That we don't need this software. If we have all the files, we don't need it. We will close that. And now we have this. We can load this into Photoshop. And then we have a Blanco canvas. What I like to do is make a folder above it with a mask, like shown here. We will create a mask like here. Then we go into the channels and we make a copy of the alpha channel. Ctrl C, Ctrl V. What this does is that everything we place in here will be weathered. Like if I now create a file, we make it wet, it will be wet and weathered. It's all done automatically for tanks. Sadly, planes don't have that feature. There is a trick for that if you're interested. I can make a short video about how to do aircraft like the helicopter we just showed. But that will be a separate video. Like now we have this, but on the vehicle we want to know where is this part, this round thing on the file. We don't, let's pretend we don't know where it is. And we want to know where it is. There comes Blender in. We will make a new Blender file. Then we remove the cube. Because fuck the cube. Cube can fuck off. And then we have two ways to go about it. Or we're going to try to export it from the asset viewer. Or the CDK. The CDK can also be used. The CDK or the asset viewer. That's totally free and is possible. But what the problem with that is that it will not look right and will have problems. Because it's not perfect. You have like a Ninja Ripper or so you can use, but it won't be perfect. So if we export it, like we, let's say we export this vehicle, it will get issues along the way because this is all camera settings. Why is it all the camera settings? Hold on. Let's say it will look like this. That's an option you have with exporting out CDK. But we will have the software for that will easily fix it and will do everything we want to or just right. It will cost a few bucks, like $5. Now €5. But then we have a website we can look up. This is Game Models 3D. And there we can easily download the file for the model. You need the object file. STL is for 3D printing. And GFL is also for an editing, but not the one we want. We want the object. So then we go into Blender. We delete the cube again because fuck the cube. And when you did go to your downloads folder and unzip the file, I have already unzipped it and have it right here. Then we go into the Blender file and then import objects. That is Wavefront object. Then we go into downloads, the Painter A, and then you just press the object folder. You don't have to load those in, but they need to be in the same folder because that's the textures and everything. And there it is. We have the Painter in Blender, but it's kind of white. So let's turn the texture on with this button. And there you go. Now we want to know where this hatch is. So we press the hatch, go into texture paint, and we will paint in the hatch. And now it says, oh, the hatch is right there. And now we can go into Photoshop and pick that part and edit it. Now we go into layout again. Let's do the skin the body. Oh, we want to skin the body. Well, let's do this place. And now we can go, oh, it's right there. Let's make this area black. And now we made this area black. And if you do this enough and mess around, you will create something like this, for example. We don't need that anymore. Let's say we made this. Well, we're going to export it as a PNG real quick. Put it in the downloads folder. This is a temporary file, so just put in downloads. Yes, we will not replace it. And then we can go to image, replace, downloads, and we replace the body. And now we see that we have a very nice body. Well, we have skinned everything and we selected everything. What you also could do is add decals inside the texture files in Blender and paint in the camouflage inside Blender. But it's not optimal and I like to prefer using Photoshop for that part or GIMP or anything else. But if you have everything done, you can press Ctrl-Alt-0 on the numpad. Not normal 0, but on the numpad. And then you have the camera. Then we open up this. And we go to View. Camera to View. Now we can pause the vehicle. And then press F12. And we have a render of it. It's not light very well, but we could easily fix that. We turn this off and add an extra light source. Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. Move the light source around. And it's better lit. And if you want it transparent, we can go to here. We go to Film, Transparent. And we can render a transparent view of the vehicle. And with this everything done, we are basically done with the skinning part and only need to do the texture file. So, oh yeah, I forgot about it. You can save this image right here, copy it or save it as. You know what to do with it. And make a beautiful thumbnail for Paladin Live or Side View or anything. With this done though, it will go back into Photoshop. We will go to Bestand or File. Opslaan als or save as. And then we go into the file we created earlier with the old DDS. And with that we will, I did the wrong one. Copy, opslaan, DDS. And then we go to the folder we were. And we save it. We wanna do DTX5. That's important, that DTX5, otherwise it messes up. And the alpha channel to none. You can also put it on, but I prefer it none. So, okay. It's saving right now. Then we go back into here. We will make a copy of the name with everything with the DDS attached. Go to the BLK. Look up the body. Body C, and then we do this name, we change it to the name we just saved, and this will tell the game that the old body texture file needs to be replaced with a new texture file. With that done, we can go into Bartender, and then select our skin, and our skin is done. This is basically how it's done. If you have questions, feel free to add it in the comments or ask me on Discord. If you don't want to pay for the game model website, feel free to hit me up on Discord and I will send you the files you need for the vehicle you want to skin. And with that, that's it. Have a good day.